Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Kerry West. I teach philosophy at the university in this town. The day on which I first met the Twonky dawned like every other Saturday in our town. Children sleeping quietly, husbands peacefully eating breakfast with their wives, citizens happily on their way to work. Yes, everything was normal in our town. Except on the roof of my house, where something new and diabolical was being added. We will now go inside my house, where I am having a pleasant conversation with Carolyn, my wife.
And the television, it was for you, to keep you company while I'm gone.
Well, darling, by the time you get back, if my classes permit, I promise you I know all the latest wrestling holds.
Gary, my cab. I'll miss my train.
I'll get your bags.
And here are a few reminders I wrote down. Now be sure that Maybell uses the new vacuum cleaner, not the old one. And in case I forgot, clean the drain spout of leaves, and don't let the hot water drip in the bathroom, and turn off the basement lights, and hang up wet towels, and...
And if I go into the dining room, wear my hat because the ceiling plaster is falling
down. That's right.
You give my regards to your sister. You tell her I checked the records. She's making obstetrical history.
Oh, I will. Oh, wait. In case I forgot, if there's ants, the poison is in on the whole shelf of the whole closet, and it's in a bottle marked waste set. And Gary, behave yourself. That's silly, isn't it? You.
Bye, Doc.
Bye.
Dear wife left to visit her sister, little knowing that inside the house, waiting for me was... But come inside with me and see for yourself.
Welcome to the happy family of television owners. First, consult your local paper for station channels and programs. Channel 2, Troubles of Trilby. Channel 6, Cowboys and Injuns. Channel 5, Pantomime Win a Ham Quiz. Channel 8, the old new time movies, etc.
Thank you. Thank you.
Gosh, I'm sorry, Professor, but I forgot to collect. And the boss will take it out of my hide if I don't turn the money in Monday morning.
Collect?
Yeah. It's supposed to be a down payment for $100. C-O-D.
But I haven't got $100. All I've got is $5. I did have $5.
It says $100.
Well, I won't pay it. I won't pay a red cent. You take it out of here. Take it out right now.
You kidding?
No.
Hey, look, it's money.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 40, 50, 60, 70, 75, 80, 90, 95. $100. I thought you said you didn't have none.
My wife, she must have left some.
Yeah, mine's got more stashed away than I'll ever have. Eh? Here's your receipt, Professor. Take it easy. I'll see you sometime Monday.
Another cup of coffee.
Who's there? Is that you, Mr. Serviceman?
Are you here, my boy?
I'm here.
Didn't your doggone tickle anymore? Do I have to fix that for you? Oh. I was hoping this would happen. When the cat's away.
To settling my nerves.
Oh, yes.
Coach Trout, I called you because I have a television set that walks.
Green?
You'll see.
I have gone. I often see television sets walking. Why, only yesterday on the football field, I saw a 12-inch set chinning itself on the crossbar.
Listen.
You have cats? Dogs? Goldfish?
Thank you.
that's impossible.
Definitely.
Not even connected. Yeah, you do it.
Oh, no. Well, if we can do all that without being plugged in.
But it's necessary for science. Come on, let's turn it around and see what's inside. One, two, three. Right. This is impossible. In the Olympic Games in Paris in 1906, I personally lifted 500 pounds. And two French women.
Oh, I think I broke my back.
No. You're suspended. We must consider this matter scientifically. Now, in the first place, have you any cold beer in the icebox?
Oh.
No? Well, then the answer's obvious. You and I will go to my place. It's much better equipped for scientific research. Why, this liqueur is nothing. It's my own formula. It's very helpful. Yogurt, blackstrap molasses, a few grapes, Tabasco sauce, and a dash of benzene. Don't be so disturbed, my boy. It's a simple case of all hallucinations induced by suggestion under mental strain. Sometimes I surprise myself.
Now, what does all that mean?
Well, everybody thinks of me as poor old Coach Trout. What does he know? Just double reverses and a Notre Dame shift. But I've studied, my boy, psychology, Freud, and Bernard McFadden. Now, you've been working very hard at the university. And for the first time in 10 years, your wife departs from you. She tells you not to take more than one cup of coffee, and she leaves a television set in her place. You're very tired, my boy. You have hallucinations that this television set is your wife. QED. 7 points on the scoreboard.
But you saw it too.
Even Einstein has holes in his theories. We have some. Spider-Man's. In the basement of this very house, I crushed the grapes with my own feet. I've got it. The answer. Freud. The great Freud. We will probe your subconscious.
What's my subconscious got to do with that infernal television set?
See. Now, I'm just lying down. Relax. I'm your friend. Now, please. Permit me to probe into the dark mysteries of your neurosis, your psychosis, whatever that is. As I remember from the book, first you close your eyes. Close your eyes. Then you relax completely. Pardon me. Vitamins. Do you mind getting up, please?
Hmm?
You look so comfortable. Thank you. Get there. Thank you. Just a minute, please. Thank you. Oh. Now we will begin. We will start with your childhood. Childhood. My childhood. My miserable childhood. I was just thinking. I'll tell you something. My football teams haven't won a game in 6 years.
Mm.
Oh, but they can't fire me. I own the first mortgage on the stadium. Women, they confuse me. All my life, whenever I think about women, I think about French fried potatoes. Why is that?
I think you should get some sleep now. Sleep now.
That television set isn't an hallucination. That's a Twonky.
Twonky?
I had Twonkies when I was a child. A Twonky is something you do not know what it is. You do not know what it is. You don't know.
If you'll excuse me now, I think I'll run on home. I've got to prepare my lecture for Monday morning.
Women.
Good morning, darling. How did you sleep? Oh,
Carol.
Good heavens, did I wake you up?
Well, no, no.
I did. What's the matter? Did you stay up late with the television set?
Carrie, are you there?
Oh, yes. I think I am.
You haven't answered me. How's the television working?
Very well. How's your sister?
Oh, she's fine. Fact of the matter is, that's why I called you. May not have to stay here as long as I expected to.
Well, that's good. That is to say, stay just as long as you want to, dear.
Oh, you're sweet. Well, I better hang up and let you go to church.
Oh, yeah, to church.
Goodbye, darling.
Goodbye, Carol.
Fuse box. Don't put your dirty sparks on my pictures. Oh, wait till the stubby gentleman of science see this. I'm going to resign this football business. A full professor of physics. That's what I'll be. Oh.
It shaved me today.
That was friendly.
It wasn't friendly. It's driving me crazy.
Please, I don't feel like dancing.
What?
Oh.
No razor, no Mozart, nothing that I want.
I've got it. He's a robot.
Robot?
A mechanical man.
Who the devil outside of Hollywood is making mechanical man?
One was made, this one. Pardon me, old chum. What are you doing?
Calling the television shop.
I wonder if you could barbecue spare rib.
Oh, it's Sunday. I forgot they're closed.
What is a single wing back formation? How many points for drop kick? Come to think of it, I don't know the answer myself. Oh, Mr. Robot. Mr. Robot, will you tie my cravat? Here, please. Wins a knot, if you please. Perhaps it serves only one master. Come, come. You try it. It is you. It serves only you. You are the master. It is your slave. How lucky you are to have such a wonder, to serve you, to protect you, to act even as a personal bodyguard. We'll experiment. One, two, three.
Coach, what's the matter?
My leg. I can't put it down.
He's an old man, you know. It's amazing, this sudden constrictor. Well, I gave him sedatives, and he'll sleep soundly until tomorrow morning. You're sure you don't want me to send a nurse?
Oh, no, no. I'll take care of him personally. And tomorrow, Maybelle, our maid, she can take over.
Well, that'll be fine. In a few days, perhaps, he can be moved back to his own place. Then you won't have any responsibility. Oh, by the way, your television set. I noticed it when I went by. It might be a good idea to have it moved upstairs and placed next to Coach Trout's bedside. In that way, it may take his mind off some of his difficulties. Is there something wrong, Mr. West?
No, no.
Well, perhaps I'd better give you some sleeping pills.
Oh, no, no, thank you. I'll be all right. I must prepare my lecture for tomorrow.
Well, then you won't need any sedatives. Well, good day. And I'm as near as your telephone.
Thank you, Doctor. I must write my lecture. I have to.
West get off all right?
Oh, yes, Mrs. West isn't here. But Coach Trower's in the bedroom. Do all the necessaries for him, will you? I've got to get to my classes. He's got a paralyzed leg.
Shirley, a what leg?
He fell down.
Mr. West, you've been having a party. Glory be. You finally got yourself a TV.
Don't you touch that.
Oh, don't you ever touch that.
Well, you could think that was something. That's only a 16-inch set. Mine's 20 inches.
Please come to order. The subject for our lecture today is
individualism in the artist.
No, I don't think so. Our lecture today will be on passion through the ages. A great artist, the beautiful Countess de Lamotte at the close of the 18th century took for herself five lovers, among whom was Louis XVI. She took a cold bath each morning and iced champagne. I don't even want to discuss it. Just take it out of my house. Out of my life. Do you hear me? Out of my life.
My dear Mr. West, may I remind you that you are beating on a delicate electronic device.
It is not. It's a low-meddling monster. It's a twonky, just like the one you sent out. It's a twonky.
My dear Mr. West, it pains me to tell you, you've been drinking.
Why is it whenever a man tells the truth, he's accused of drinking?
Please go shout elsewhere.
I'm not shouting. I'm just telling you from the bottom of my soul. Get that infernal instrument out of my house at once. I'll not tolerate another instant.
Please. My dear Mr. West, according to our records, you are not the contractor.
I'm not the what?
You are not the contractor. Mrs. West contracted for this set. Ergo, and to wit, Mrs. West is the only one who could make any claims about it.
I'm not making any claims about it. I'm making statements. It's a lethal instrument. It's a state executioner. And I demand you take it out of my house immediately.
Mr. West, I have had many years' experience in time payment merchandising. And in all that experience, I've had many husbands who tried to cash in on their wife's purchases in order to get some money to spend on heaven knows what. I will be no party to this. Your wife's $100 was banked this morning. And that, as they say, is that. Of course, your set is not working correctly. The outside aerial has not been connected. Now, I will give you a repairman. I will even go further than that. I will give you a new set. But I will not cancel your wife's order.
Crazy house, back in Gleaners and television. Back in Gleaners and television. Crazy, crazy.
Please, Captain Gould, please. Is this where Coach Trout is staying? Oh, please. Coach Trout, where are you?
Here I am, come on out.
Come in, come in, boy. Oh, my dear football team.
How
I've been waiting for you.
As soon as the backfield told me about your phone call, we came right over. We want to know, how do you feel?
Oh, well, I'll expect your sympathy later. Now then, men, are you with me?
Of course they are. Even if we haven't won a game in 6 years.
You talk too much. I want you to do something for me, for the old school. I want you to go downstairs and find crowbars, pickaxes, and then go in that living room downstairs and hit the line. Smash the twonking.
the Twonky?
The television set. The television set. To infinite bits. Even more.
But, Coach, they haven't been televising our game.
No, I'm serious. Now, listen to me. Go down there and ruin that television set.
But, Coach...
Shut up, Susie. Come on, fellas. You heard the coach. Let's go.
Now, halfbacks, you use the crowbars. Sneak around in. And fullback, you smash the back. And quarterback, you sneak around the end. Set. One, two, three, fight. One, two, three, fight.
Oh, miss.
Yes, coach?
You better go, too. I'm in no condition today for French fries.
Hurry up, I want to make the substitution.
My backfield. Where's my backfield?
I'll be with you in a minute, coach.
Wow, what a fun.
Kerry, answer me. Where are my backfield? The backfield.
I'll be with you in a minute.
What happened?
Answer me, tell me.
No complaint.
You, tell me what's happened.
I have no complaint. I am going home.
What's happened to you, man?
No complaints.
Please tell me what's happened.
No complaints.
You, tell me what's happened here.
No complaints.
You, tell me what's happened.
I have no complaints. I am going home.
How do you like them characters? I'm telling you, them kids would drink anything.
Kerry, Kerry, what's going on down there? Speak to me.
Come in.
They mix benzene and that uranium stuff, and they call it cocktails. Well, what's the matter with you? How do you like that? No power, no aerial. Then they blame it on the set. Stupid. Well, I'll connect up the new one. The boss says. Guy like him needs entertainment. His wife gone away. He's as lonesome as a hound dog locked out on a rainy day. Okay, baby. Out you go. Hey, what the? Hey. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Model Series K72 reporting. Message for the Bureau of Entertainment. My client is lonely. Send over immediately one blonde female, age 18 to 20.
Mr. Can I admit this? Please. I'll call the police. I'll call the Vice Squad.
I understand this Twonky now. I've been telephoning my scientific friends. They tell me we already have robots in this world of ours. The only trouble is, a super atomic brain like that one down there, why, that one can think, reason, make its own choices.
disguise itself. It can wriggle around under its own power. They tell me that the Voyage of Science, the sanctuary, is away from that.
Then it is from another world.
No, from our world. Sanctuaries in the future.
What the devil are you talking about?
I'm telling you, one of these robots, one of these twiddling twankies of the future time, has fallen through its own dimension of time into ours.
Fallen through time?
Don't you read science fiction? Our universe is curved. Einstein proved that. Well, now, if our universe is curved, then so is time. This is the past, the present, and the future. It's all from here to here.
But it's only a television set.
The form of a television set. I mean that. When it fell out of its dimension, time, into ours, it fell into a television production factory line, or into that television shop. With its superintelligence, it knew at once where it was and the danger to it, so it immediately changed its form into a form that we would understand, a form to be quite safe and acceptable. Who knows what it looks like? Strange cars and wheels, horrible plastic flesh, synthetic blood.
Why me? Why does it have to pick on me?
I believe that in the world of the future where this twankie comes from, every house, every family has a twankie of its own to carry on the dictates of the super state. Yes, the super state. He's a secret detective, but he's not secret. There's one place in every home to serve, to regulate every thought according to the dictates of the super state. He's now carrying on that function with you.
We've got to get rid of it. We'll smash it to pieces. I've got a crowbar in the garage.
No.
The serviceman! Got you too.
I fall down. You shouldn't have done it.
Oh, I wasn't even in the room.
You shouldn't have tied its feet down.
It isn't nailed to the floor.
I can't turn it around. You got bolts shoved through the floor? You a magician?
It's a robot.
We don't carry that kind.
A mechanical man.
It's our model 17K12.
No, I am robot 743B32, experimental model series K72.
You see what I mean? Now take it out of here. Take it out of here at once.
I'll tell the boss.
Tell them. Yes, tell them everything. Tell them it's from the future. Are you hurt?
I don't know what you're talking about. I feel fine.
I'm going home now. I got no complaints.
You've made it quite clear to me. I understand this mechanism now. Will you stop hiking up and down and listen to me? There's no doubt that this robot is capable of creating a mental block in your head. An electric wave enters the brain and eliminates that which the twanky doesn't want you to think. And to put ideas in your head, too. Those words, no complaint. That was the twanky talking.
Oh, it talked. It came out of the loudspeaker.
What?
Yes, it said something about a robot or something. An experimental model.
Experimental? Then we must eliminate it at once. If it's an experimental model, perhaps then there's only one. Eliminate it, and we can change the future.
I'll call the police.
Criminal, not the authorities. Do you want the Twanky to come up here in the form of a policeman? Yeah, why not? He changed his form once, he could do it again. To Boris Koloff, or Santa Claus, or even Satan himself. We must neutralize it while it's in that television form right down there now. We must think, act. What would New Drockney do at a time like this?
I told Carolyn not to buy anything on the installment plan.
I've got it. The answer. I can eliminate it at once. In a few moments, your twanky will twank no more.
What? Hollow. It operates only when it thinks it can help me or when its own security is threatened. You tried to kick me, paralyze your leg. And now you threatened it again with extinction. Jump down! Oh my God! Oh my God!
You made a mistake, mister, opening up in this neighborhood.
I? My boy, start confessing. Are you in an illicit business? Basketball?
Nobody up here, Sergeant.
Where are all those dames? Answer me, where are those dames?
Dames?
Who are you plotting for? Who's that blonde you're trying to get?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You call up on that telephone and ask the blonde to be sent over here.
I did.
Yes, you. The telephone company told me all about it.
I said?
Oh. Won't speak up!
What's the use of talking? You'd never believe me.
Duffel! How'd you guys get onto this?
Who the devil are you?
Treasury Department. How'd you guys get onto this case?
Treasury Department? What's the matter? Didn't those dames pay your income tax?
What dames? This guy's a counterfeiter.
Kerry, my boy, you have been naughty.
$95 of the sweetest counterfeit bills you ever saw.
$95?
You!
Yeah, I know you paid for the television with it. Alcatraz is calling, brother.
No, it wasn't I. It was the Twonky. The Twonky did it, not I. It's a robot, a mechanical man. Can talk, can do anything. You'll see.
Oh, death, where is thy sting?
Nothing, Stevie!
Oh, life, where is thy
Gary!
He's got television in his closet.
Okay, that's enough. Come on, brother.
No!
Well, yeah. Bring me that television. Unless you interrupt me, take me in motion. Please, no foul. Pistol pow! Pistol pow! Pistol pow! After all these years, boy, I think you'll need a drink of my formula. And a hacksaw.
Hello? Hello, is that you, Carrie? It's Carolyn. Sister Ellie had her baby. 6 pounds and...
Hello, are you the female from the Bureau of Entertainment?
Who is this? Who am I talking to? Where are you talking from?
This is 432 Maple Street. Come at once. My client will be home soon.
Well, I never. Anne! Anne, where is my suitcase?
Love Moll, Megan, Marion, and Marjorie. But none of us cared for Kate. I'm sober. Cold sober. Well, that's forbidden too, eh? A man can't even escape into that in your time, can he? What is it in your time? Yes, sir, no, sir. Thank you for my chain, sir. Well, go back to your time. I don't want you, I don't need you. What good are you anyway? Security? Sure, I want security, but not at your price. I may be wrong, but it'll be my kind of wrong. It's my God-given right to be wrong. Go back! Go back now!
Hello. May I come in? The door was open a little.
I beg your pardon.
The neighbors told me.
little wife isn't at home, is she?
Well, young lady, I'm afraid you've made a mistake. The wrong house.
Mistake?
I think so. I've had a miserable day. You wouldn't believe it, but... Oh, it's past 10. I wonder, would you mind?
A drink?
Young lady...
Radiator.
Young lady, didn't you hear me? It's almost 11 o'clock. I'm in no mood for discussions on chemicals.
All right. I haven't burned out my vocal cords. We'll get down to business.
Goodbye.
Rest yourself.
I'm not that fatigued.
$86.56.
I beg your pardon?
I'll tell you a story. Once there was a lady who was married to a professor of something at the university, and she loved to buy things. So she did. End of story. Except sometimes she lost her memory about paying.
You're a bill collector.
Let's put it this way. I bring economic justice to the poor storekeeper left holding the bag. For instance, this department store in Sioux City, Iowa.
My wife said she sent them the money a year ago.
Uh-huh. Stamp must have fell off. We've taken over the account. I'm just a poor little girl making her way in the world. Want to make with the checkbook?
Carolyn.
The Yucca Collection Agency, that's me. That's I. That's $86.56. You'll save all the court costs?
You might as well give me a piece of rubber to write it on. It didn't bounce anyway.
You mean you live in this magnificent railroad station and haven't got $86.56?
My wife inherited it from a grandmother who hated me. Aren't you leaving?
No.
But you can't just sit there.
I'm built for it.
But, my dear young lady, it's almost midnight.
Mm-hmm. And then it'll be 1 o'clock, and then 2 o'clock, and then 3 o'clock.
But a man of my position, I can't have you here.
$86.56.
But I haven't got 56 cents. Tomorrow. I get my check from the university tomorrow.
Wonderful. I'll wait.
But you can't wait here. I've explained it to you.
And I'll explain it to you. With my last 500 bucks, I bought up some old accounts. Hot ones, the man said. Well, all day long, I've walked my dogs off trying to collect them. And everybody's either dead or in the army or moved to places like Equinox, Nova Scotia, or Florida, or New Hampshire. All except you. I'll wait.
This is trespassing. I'll call the police.
Will you?
Oh, no. No! Don't stand there. Do something. Do something. You hear me? Do something. Now's your chance. Do something. Now's your chance.
I saw you staggering down the street. Brother.
All day long when I didn't need you, you were sparking away. Well, spark now. 86.56.
Good night. Don't forget to lock your door.
Kelly, all right. Are you all right? Expose your tongue to me.
What?
Expose your tongue to me. Quickly.
Doctors always do this. To me, it's just another tongue.
Coach, I haven't got time to play housey with you. I'll see you at the university.
No, I want to talk to you now. You were acting very peculiar last night. I have a vague memory that you were discussing my lens. You've been concentrating too much. Why don't you relax in the evenings? Stay at home and enjoy your new television set.
That's the Twonky. Now he's a girl.
Yeah. Turn off that radio. I am going to psychoanalyze you.
No, Coach, and where are you?
I don't see you at the university. First thing you know, you'll find your brand new...
Good morning, Professor.
Huh?
I have come for the set.
Set?
Television. Two of them.
Dawes sent me over for the busted one.
Oh.
You want to know something? I got no complaints. On the way over here, some guy smacks right into my front fender. No insurance. $50 it'll cost.
You really think you could take it out?
This morning, my wife, she's dishing out the coffee. She gives a sneeze. In my lap, the whole pot.
No, I can't let you do it. You're in bad enough shape as it is. It'll blitz you again if you do it.
What's the matter, mister? I got no complaints. The set's no good. I'm taking it away.
You really think you can lift it?
Are you kidding? Come on, baby. You want a receipt?
No, no. Agency, I'd like to talk to you.
Haven't you gone to pick up your check?
I've got a little proposition I want to make to you.
Well?
Please. Please come this way.
Oh, that's your call.
There.
There what?
You take that for your 8656.
Are you kidding?
Well, it's virtually brand new, only 2 days old.
What's wrong with it?
Oh, I assure you, it operates most efficiently.
Is it hot?
So cold.
Can you give me a bill of sale?
If necessary, written with my own blood.
Well, you don't have to go that far. Wait a minute.
Huh?
Yesterday, you kicked this thing. I saw you. What are you trying to do, sell me a lemon?
Well, it's quite intact.
No sale.
Get out. In 5 minutes.
What?
If you're not out of here in 5 minutes, I'll kill myself. You hear me? That's what I'll do. I'll kill myself. I'll take poison and end it all.
Hey, you come back here. Of all the clumps. Okay, poison yourself. But leave 8656 on the table. What a common man. Try to sell me a no good television.
I'll be back.
Be careful.
I guess I'll go to the meeting now. It's an important one. We're going to draft a new Declaration of Independence.
Come on, I haven't got all day. Don't just stand there, get in.
Wes, I have a letter. I beg you.
Pull in your antenna, your electrified bloodhound, and get in.
I ran out of gas. My wife is having a baby at the city hospital. Hurry, please.
Oh, get in. Get in. I've just finished changing the tire.
Hurry, please. Hurry.
Beastly bored tire changing.
What's that?
I forgot to close it. You silly men. Always running out of petrol. But I'll get you there in plenty of time. I visited your city hospital only yesterday. I bought this vehicle upon my arrival in New York. I believe it is what you Americans call a hack law.
You're going very fast.
Of course I am.
Nail drivers.
Look, look.
Trying to tell me how to manipulate my own vehicle?
Lady, listen. I lied. I'm not going to have a baby at all. Please stop.
Really, I told you that I'd get you to a city hospital before your infant was born. And I will. Now stop telling me how to drive.
But you're on the wrong side of the roads.
Not in England, I'm not.
But you're not in England.
Young man, this was once an English colony. And as far as I'm concerned, it still is.
But you're wrong!
At my age, it's my God-given right to be wrong.
You're absolutely right. It's your God-given right to be wrong.
Oh,
You smell something burning?
Only my temper.
It's getting hot in here.
Ah! What the devil?
But Swansea, please stop! Ah!
Don't try to talk, dear.
I... What? Who?
Oh, you're fine. You've got a smashed fibula, a broken ulna, and a fractured tibia.
The Twonky.
Well, the police found it in the wreckage. The Twonky's just all smashed to smithereens.
Oh. Maybe I fix the future, huh?
Never do that. I'll always like my own. Never forget that.
Oh, there you are. I heard all about your mishap while you were returning the television set to the store for repairs. And for your convalescence, I got a great surprise for you. All right, man, bring it in. It's the exact duplicate of the one you had. Isn't that nice?